Can't Paddy give you a hand?
He's gone to ask permission from Mandy's father. The wedding's back on for now. Look, tell me honestly, is it enough?
It's fine, honestly, stop fussing. It's only Betty and a few oiks from the yard.
They're not all oiks. Anyway, you should be grateful to me. I'm showing the caring face of the Tates.
Well, why bother? I don't.
Quite. So, how do I look?
Nice. Really.
And you wonder why women don't throw themselves at you.
Speaking of which, I better go. Well, I'm sorry I can't stay. Party full of lesbians and lorry drivers right up my street.
You're a disgrace.
What?
Dragging Laura out from here with your ex-wife on my birthday.
I am not dragging Laura out.
Oh, so you're telling me she wants to have dinner with Kathy?
No, I'm telling you, she's not coming.
Chris?
She's working late.
What are you up to?
What are you up to? A lot of effort to go to for a bunch of truckers.
You are either a very tolerant or a very stupid man.
Meaning?
Meaning trusting Chris with Kathy. It's like trusting Tom to look after Jerry.
I don't trust Chris, okay? I trust Kathy.
Yeah, move on. Chris is picking me up.
Listen, you don't have to go, you know.
I promised him. If you knew, I'd rather spend it with you. Oh, I'll be Chris now. Better go. Sort of get changed. See you.
You can't hide in here forever. Come on, we've got a babysitter sorted. We may as well go down the pub.
I don't want to.
Why not?
Because I've just been arrested. Everyone will be talking about me.
No, they won't. It'll do you good. Better than being stuck in here, brooding.
I don't even know how that stuff got in there.
Like I said, it was probably just a prank by one of the kids.
Oh, some prank! Planting dope on me the day the police come to the school. I could lose my job.
I'm sure it won't come to that.
Even if it was one of the kids, they're not going to admit to it, are they?
Come on. It's not that bad. Hey, it's all right. Look, we'll have a word with Laura tomorrow, see what she's got to say. And I can talk to Miss Strickland.
Thank you. If it wasn't for you...
Stop worrying. We'll sort it out, I promise you.
Come on, Chris, Rachel's not the type.
Oh, I don't know. Sometimes wonder if she didn't slip something in my tea. Another reason why I married her.
That's a terrible thing to say.
I'm serious. But I think what's best for Joseph.
Exactly. You stood up for me, didn't you, after the accident?
It was different.
In what way?
Because you were the victim of a crime, not the perpetrator.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Chris, you don't believe Rachel's guilty, do you?
Let's not fall out about it. The whole point of tonight was to stop the arguing.
No. No, you're right. So where are we going?
Not saying. Surprised.
It's a shame Laura couldn't make it.
Yeah. Yes, it is, isn't it?
You've invited Sean.
I've invited everyone from the yard. Now I don't want any trouble.
Ah, well, maybe you shouldn't ask them then. Happy now won't be stopping.
Good.
You okay?
What? Yeah, sorry, you know what it's like when you're waiting for people to arrive.
Oh, so who else is coming apart from him?
Lots of gorgeous women.
Maybe I will stay.
Hello. Happy birthday.
On second thoughts.
Thank you. Just, Oh, you brought Viv with you. Thank you.
Nice dress. Oh, not that you needed to bother. Looks like I'm the only single woman here.
I wouldn't count on it.
Hiya.
Come in. Just help yourself to drink. Hi. Hello. Thank you for coming.
Here. I thought we could save it for later.
Happy birthday.
Thanks. I was beginning to think that you lot weren't coming.
Oh, we had a problem with one of the lorries.
Oh.
Frankie's staying up there till it's sorted. Well, I asked her if she didn't mind. Seeing as you weren't that bothered about her coming. Still, if they get a move on, shouldn't take more than an hour or so. Well, cheer up. It's not all bad. You play your cards right, you get me as the consolation prize.
I don't believe it, Chris.
You like it?
This place costs a fortune.
I don't care.
I do.
You're not paying. It's my treat. You go inside, I'll park the car.
Thank you.
Reception upstairs for the right one.
Oh, it's all right, I know the way. We spent our wedding night here.
Rachel's not that kind of a girl.
Ask Angie.
Ask Angie what?
Rachel Hughes and her drug problem.
I'm off duty, Viv.
Unlike your husband.
Don't worry. I've seen it all before. He's just flattered by the attention.
Lad like that. Don't need to be flattered.
You're telling me.
Still no sign of Frankie. Here. You'll be needing this.
Oh. What is it?
Anesthetic. For when that lot get going. Room full of truckers. One lonely but attractive woman.
Yes, who happens to be a lesbian.
Minor detail, believe me. It's not that the sex is mine. They're all for equal opportunities, if you know what I mean.
I think I can handle them.
Still, if you have any trouble...
Yeah, you'll rescue me. Well, don't worry, because I'm a vet and I know plenty of ways of dealing with oversexed animals, if you see what I mean.
I'd risk it.
I wouldn't. Excuse me.
So, what did you say this time? What you need's a real man to show you what you're missing.
What are you talking about?
You're pathetic, do you know that?
Yeah, thank you.
Zoe, happy birthday. Good grief, it's like Sodom and Gomorrah.
I wish.
Any problem, sir?
No. I think I've sorted it.
Oh, very good.
I feel like I'm on display.
Rubbish. Nobody said anything to you, have they?
No. But I know that they're talking about me.
No, they're not. I bet most of them don't even know. Or don't care. You've got nothing to worry about.
Bayek. How do, comrade? What can I get you?
I'm fine.
Butch, get a drink for the lady. What are you having like?
Honestly, you don't have to.
Oh, it's the least I can do for a fellow fugitive. Who'd have thought you'd being done for wacky-backy?
Zach, I wasn't.
Oh, of course you weren't. Our Marlon told me all about it. See this woman? She is a victim of rough justice. Don't worry about it, love. Hey, you're in good company.
Now can we go?
Zach's getting you a drink.
I'm telling everyone the gory details. Graham, I'm not exactly enjoying myself.
Relax. Who cares what they say? We're perfectly entitled to be here.
Put a stop to that.
Yes.
I must say, I'm surprised.
I'm not. You know what they say about Merry Widows.
No. I mean about the party. Didn't think Zoe would enjoy this sort of thing.
By the look of it, I don't reckon she is.
No. It's not that. I mean, she was an... What?
I think we should go.
I don't want to.
I do.
Well, don't let me stop you.
Aren't you going with her?
Who?
Your wife.
she appears to be leaving.
I may join the company.
The company or the challenge?
A bit of both.
It won't work.
What?
You know what I mean.
And I thought I was irresistible to women.
Don't worry, you're all man. That being the problem.
If it makes it easier, I can get in touch with my feminine side. See? You can't resist me.
Thank you.
That was bliss. You know, I haven't been to a place like this since...
You were married to me? Might have been a terrible husband, but let's face it, Red Star.
But not substance.
Thanks very much.
I suppose you had some good points. In fact, being here, it reminds me... You know, I miss it sometimes.
Flattered?
Not you, your credit card. It's a shame.
What?
Nothing.
It's too late now. You're madly in love with Biff.
That's none of your business, Chris. Come on, let's get going. I promised Biff I wouldn't be late.
I'll settle up.
At least Zach believes you.
Yeah.
Even if the rest of them don't.
Just saying, until we're sure she's not done anything.
She hasn't. I know Rachel. She's not the sort.
Believe me, I've seen it all before. Work gets about, and we don't want a reputation of a pub that allows that sort of thing.
That sort of thing has never gone on in this pub, and as long as I'm in charge, it won't. We're not going to get drug pushers and heaven knows what else just because Rachel's got a spot of trouble.
Yes. I don't believe it. Right, that's it. I'm going home.
No, you're staying put.
Now, what can I get you?
You should offer to buy her a drink, son. You get on with pigs.
Pint, please, Alan.
Mr. Reynolds not with you tonight?
He's over at Zoe's party, getting to know the neighbours.
And you're leaving him to it?
No point me stopping. I know most of the villagers already. I've arrested half of them.
Come on. I don't understand. It was okay before. Come on. Dead as a doornail.
We could try borrowing some jump leads.
No, I don't think it's the battery. It's a brand new one.
There must be something. What about asking at reception?
It's a hotel, not a service station.
Chris, it's ridiculous. I suppose you could try phoning Lisa.
This time of the night.
Taxi.
No, it's too far. They'd never take us.
Well, that just leaves hitching.
Yeah, right. What are you going to do with me? Tie me to the bumper and tow me?
All right, stupid idea.
I suppose there's only one thing for it. Just have to stay here.
Chris, it isn't your fault. I think I better phone Biff.
It's okay. I spoke to Laura. She's gonna let him know.
Oh. All right then.
I don't suppose... for a nightcap.
Have you seen Kathy?
No, of course I haven't.
Well, they should have been back ages ago. Where are they?
Oh, didn't she phone you?
No.
Chris phoned me.
When?
About half an hour ago. They've broken down and they're going to stop over at the hotel.
You believe that?
Yes, why shouldn't I?
Well, you know what Chris is like.
Yeah, I do, which is why it doesn't worry me. Don't know about Kathy, though.
No, it's stupid.
No,
Oh. Well, how come she didn't phone you then?
Night, Biff.
I'm fine.
Look, would you like me to start asking people to leave?
No. No, it's early, and anyway, not everyone's here yet.
Well, it's gone 10 o'clock. I mean, who else is going to come?
Help! So, Viv Windsor, I tell you, it's like dancing with an octopus. Hands everywhere and lethal suction ever.
How about a dance?
You asking?
I'm asking.
Get stuffed.
You don't know what you're missing till you try it.
I did try it, I didn't like it.
You know, she should have been finished by now. Yeah. Pity that. Obviously couldn't be bothered.
What are you talking about?
Frankie. She isn't gonna turn up.
You were saying? Hi!
Happy birthday. I'm sorry I'm late.
I'm so glad you're here.
She terrifies me.
Oh. Laura. She's a pussycat.
She's a real man-eating tiger.
What about you and Biff? How are you getting along?
Fine. Yeah, he gets on with Alice. He's great company and he loves me.
What about you?
What about me?
Do you love him?
Chris, what sort of question is that?
No, go on. Satisfy my curiosity. Do you love him?
Mind your own business, Chris. Biff's good for me.
Yeah, like a dose of cod liver oil.
Stop it. The thing about Biff is...
What?
Nothing. It's just what I need right now. I feel safe with him. It's comfortable. Now, I look at Biff and I think, why wasn't I with him right from the start?
You can't justify a relationship on the grounds it's the proper thing to do. Love, it's a chemical reaction. It doesn't just happen in your head. It's the whole point.
Yeah, well, maybe I should have followed my head more often. Now, I don't want to be swept off my feet 1 minute and then dumped the next. I'd like someone I can rely on, someone I can trust.
Sounds exciting.
Believe you me, Chris, I've had enough excitement to last me a lifetime.
Good job you're with Biff, then.
It's been a nightmare. Sean's been trying to convert me all night.
Sorry.
So pleased you're here. Yeah, there's something I wanted to ask you, only I know I'm drunk, but I was just wondering. I mean, what I'm trying to say is, would you like to go out with me?
What?
Well, for a drink, I don't know, a meal, something, anything, whatever you like.
Yeah, why not?
Right, that's wonderful, that's wonderful.
We'd love to.
Weed.
Zoe, this is Maggie.
Maggie.
Hi. Frank is partner.
Her partner?
Yeah, her partner.
Really? Really? Congratulations, that's great. That's really...
I don't know why I'm doing this. I don't have to explain myself to you.
Seems to me you wanted to talk about it.
You brought it up.
Yeah. And you ran with it. Come on, Kathy. You spent half the night trying to justify why you're with Biff. It wasn't for my benefit, was it?
You're wrong.
I don't think so.
It's my life, Chris. Just give it a rest.
I don't want you to do something you might regret.
What, like marrying you? You do it all the time, don't you? Latching onto people. And do you know why? Because you're sad, Chris. You're sad, lonely, apathetic, and you think it'll make us take notice of you. Sorry, I didn't mean that.
No, it's okay. I was out of order. It's none of my business.
No.
But I honestly think you're making a mistake with Biff.
Rubbish, you just don't like him.
No, I don't. It wouldn't matter if you loved him.
No, I don't believe you. It could be anybody, Chris, and you'd still be sticking your nose in. You set all this up, didn't you? Didn't you?
Yes. Oh, come on, Kathy. I didn't drag you into the car, restaurant, or my bedroom. If you want to think I did all the running, then fine, if that's what you want to believe.
How dare you?
Well, at least I'm being honest. Stop playing the martyr. It doesn't suit you. I did it because I had to talk to you. I thought it might do some good. I was wrong.
Too right.
Go on, do what you usually do. Ignore the problem and run away. If you stay with Biff, you'll regret it. But then you don't really need me to tell you that, do you?
I'll tell you something, Chris. I do love Biff. I love him more than I ever loved you. I'd tell you all about what it's like with him. I'd give you the details about just how passionate he can be, but a man in your position, you wouldn't want to know. I'm going to call a taxi. You won't mind if I put it on your bill.
Right, that's it. I'm going.
Why?
Because we've made our point. It's getting late. We've got to get back for Joseph.
Not until she leaves.
Oh, this is stupid.
Satisfied?
I'm sorry?
You know Rachel's going to lose her job because of you.
Graham, this isn't helping.
Exactly. Don't make things worse than they already are.
You don't honestly think she was responsible for bringing drugs into the school?
This is neither the time or the place.
I really want to go home.
Why would I ask you into the school if Rachel was taking drugs? Do you think I'm an idiot?
Do you really want me to answer that? Now, if you'll excuse me.
Graham!
Now, stop that! Get off me! I said... I'm so sorry.
Granddad?
Call an ambulance. Let's have a count.
Okay. Granddad?
Stand back, give us some room.